I'm Marius and welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays. Right now I'm working on the damper lever for the vibraphone. I just bent the lever itself. That's basically the lever.
And that's for the vibraphone.
Yeah, that's the vibraphone. Let's see. Okay, Martin is going to demonstrate the dampening. So, do we have a mallet?
I have a screwdriver.
Wait, is there?
You see my foot here? When I hold it down, we have long notes. When I release it, there comes a felt who dampens all the notes. Short, long. And the lever Marius is building is going to do what this sustain pedal is doing. So it's kind of a sustain lever.
Yeah. I was basically responsible for the dampening system for the vibraphone. So Martin had a lot of design ideas in CAD already or just in his head. And we basically brainstormed together how to make it the best. And first I made a prototype from cardboard to see how much room I need. If it hits, for example, with the part that Martin made this week, the cymbal drop points. And so when we were satisfied with how it fits and how it looks, I made a smaller, more sleeker finished part out of steel. I welded it and bent it a little bit.
Yeah. And on the tip of there is going to be this dampening felt. Yeah, I think it looks so great. And you can see here also, Hannes, that if you do it again, Marius, that this vibraphone note can pivot on this shaft, but it's free from this. So the shaft it pivots on is actually the shaft that is doing this movement. So pretty elegant, if I can say it myself. What do you think, Hannes?
I'm not sold on the cardboard.
Today I'm working on the lever we prototyped yesterday. And this morning I already welded this L shape and drilled some holes into it on the other side as well so we can attach it.
I think it's so brilliant that we have our maybe first part on the Marius MMX that is not completely overbuilt. I love the scale of this 2 mm by 10 mm that you used, Marius. I think it's...
Yeah, it's just strong enough. Right now I'm welding on the connection point at the lever for the vibraphone damper. Mm. That's here. At least I'm trying to. Let's see how good I am.
We're gonna weld on the machine.
On the machine, yeah.
Yes.
And then that was basically the first task, to just mount that on the machine and see how it looks and see where it can go, where there's room for it. And then just letting it stay there. And the other part for that lever is that it has to stay in place when we let go of it. So I built a catch system with a felt in it so that there's enough friction that it stands. And in any position, you leave it there. I could move on to the dampener themselves. That's basically these arcs with the attachment point for the felt. And I bent them. I just first made a prototype again out of welding wire. And then, yeah, I made the prototype. I made one version out of the final material to see how it will look. And from that, I basically made a jig to bend all 11 of them together. Made and then batch produced all 11 of those levers and attached the attachment plates for the felt. That's a lot of just a small plate with 2 screws in it. Just welded it on to clean it up a little bit.
So, starting of day 3, what are
really?
You up to, Marius?
Day 3?
Day 3.
Okay, yeah, so I'm continuing parts for the vibraphone dampener, so that's the prototype. And I'm making the plates that go here, and then making them a little bit smaller so that we can use a smaller felt, not as wide. Yeah, so I'm making 11 of these plates, drill them, countersink them, and then weld them on and try them out and see if it fits everything. Done!
Yes, sweet!
At least with this step. Yeah, so after we welded on these plates, on the both the holders for the felt. Now I'm welding the holders to the shaft here so that they're part of the model machine. Then the last step will be to attach the felt, and then the dampeners are finished.
You took some really good design decisions. I wanted this to be bent and then have several bends, and you really fought for this to only have bend in one plane and do this diagonal design. And now when I see it, I'm like, good, I listened to Marius on this one. That was really good. There's a design Easter egg, because I put this, Richard made these arms, and then I put these slots in, and then Richard says, but it's a marble drop, so you have to put the marble in. So that little hole there is an abstraction of a marble that is dropping down. So Marius found this felt in a super specialized felt store in Munich, right?
Yes, it's right inside the town hall. The old town hall.
But she has only felt in the whole store.
Yeah, she's only sheets of felt. That's everything she sells.
Marius, your first task, the final day?
Yeah, the first task is attaching the felt to the vibraphone.
Ooh.
It's basically the last step for this. Apart from tightening some screws, but yeah, that's basically the last assembly step. It's funny that the felt tightens so quite interestingly, and it's really strong on there. Okay. Awesome, that's the last screw. Now the felts are attached. Now only tightening the set screws and the dampener should work.
First try.
So good. So we're tweaking the position of the dampeners. So the wave inside this plate has a node here and here. And when you put your finger on the node of the vibration, it doesn't dampen it. So nothing happens there. Closer to the center, immediately silent. So we're gonna move this further down. I thought we're gonna have a longer felt, so I asked Marius to build them higher up. But now we decided it looks so cool with a shorter felt. So now we're moving them further down. And the ultimate goal is to have the vibraphone play the popcorn song and get it into Alex's brain.
Permanently.
Permanently. Forever.
No, it's not centered, but better.
It looks good. Oh.
Oh.
That is short. Yeah. So you should try. Do you see that lever there, the longest one?
This one?
Try lifting it.
Okay. Okay, let me first try to find out what it does. Yeah. Okay. Oh, that's the muting, isn't it? Oh, nice. And just ever so slightly.
Yeah.
Just not to be rude.
Just enough.
Yeah.
And okay. We have to put them in the correct order. Wait. Yeah.
It doesn't
try.
It doesn't have to be either.
No, that's not done yet.
Very nice. Okay, guys.
Are we ready to show Chris the piece I think he's gonna like the most?
I think so, yeah.
I'm not sure you... The level of expectation is very high.
Should I get it?
Yeah. Yes. Bring it.
Okay.
Ta-da!
Wow! Oh, I love it. Temporary. Okay.
Play music.
Oh.
Or make noise at least.
But I don't want to hurt your feelings too much.
No, it's lovely.
Okay.
It's lovely.
Okay. So this is the type of things that allows you to use the machine as would be without having the finished part.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because now all the marbles are catch. And they're packed in the metal.
So it's not a really good song yet.
I think it's a good thing to have like a deadline, like this intensive week to have stuff ready for. Like, do you have to order parts so that you can do something here on the intensive week? And then the project moves forward, and it's also like a big motivator for Martin, I think, because he just has to work on the machine alone, and it's a bit slow, and maybe he loses motivation or something. And then there's every half year or a year, there's another intensive week where three, four people come and want to work on the machine and bring in a lot of enthusiasm, I think it's a good thing to move the project forward.
So thank you as always, Marius,
for
bringing awesome work, awesome personality.
Yeah, thank you for being here as well. It's always nice seeing you again.
Yes, that's what I was waiting for, giving me praise. Thank you, Marius.
Good.
See you on next Wintergatan Wednesday.